Coach, you've had these guys hostage for pretty much a week almost now. What have you, you feel like you've gotten done, you know, what you wanted to? Or?
Well, not really, because, you know, we would have liked to have had Robert. But I do think that, you know, the decision to do that, I think he feels better about it, which is the most important thing, is that he, you know, in his mind, he just wanted to feel like he could play without, like he I sat down with him. I actually went through tape with him and said, show me, does it hurt here? Does it hurt there? And he just said to me, I just feel constant pressure. And so I think in his own mind, he felt like it's the right thing to do. And I do think that Chad and Garrett are doing a good job trying to get him back as quickly as possible. But I wish we had him, because this has been a great time to do some things that we've wanted to do. And we have added some different things, but a big part of what we've tried to do is really try to stay in front of the ball so we can keep our position, so we can rebound the ball better.
And everything okay with him and come through
Robert? Yeah, he's good. He's good, and he is. He's doing great.
Any,
I think.
Any expectation for when he might get back? Or
I mean, our expectations would be as soon as possible, obviously. But we're not going to put him in a position where we don't give the surgery a chance to be successful. But he's doing what he needs to do, and you know, your hope would be he could get back for the next game, but probably highly unlikely. But the fact is, that's what we're shooting for. But that means he also comes back without very much practice.
Have you seen any improvement defensively over the course of this week?
Well, I think I've seen where guys understand that we have to get better. I mean, but it's learning to play defense is no different than trying to shoot the ball. You've got to get reps after reps after reps, and really, it's a willingness to want to defend somebody. And with the rules, I mean, and I do know that the game is being officiated different, especially guarding the ball. And but we're not asking anyone to guard the ball by themselves. We want to have, you know, really good support behind us. But when you let people just go right by you without any resistance, it's virtually impossible to rebound the ball, because, you know, teams get you into those rotations and then you just totally lose positioning and space on the floor where you really can't rebound it. So we have to really try to do a better job of fighting to stay in front of the ball.
What changes down low? Obviously, Jabari brought energy and effort off the bench when he did get minutes, but how does that change, his absence change the other guys' roles and minute loads and stuff?
Well, what he did, and you mentioned the energy, that's what we should be getting from everybody. That's what we've talked about. You know, I mean, we think Derek Reese should be a high-energy guy. I do think that Kyle is getting better. We've made a conscious effort, not only with Kyle, but with Reese, with all of our post guys, to try to put the ball in there a little bit more to them to see, and just, we got to develop them. Whether it shows up here in the next week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, at some point in time, we need to have a presence in there. And we know that Kyle's young and he hadn't played very much, and Ray has the ability. He just has to understand consistency of it. But we have spent time the last couple of days really trying to have a presence down there offensively, and again, it's not just with Armani, it's with again, I think Reese should be a guy that could go in there and score, but we need energy from all those guys. I mean, but more than anything, we need our perimeter guys to do their job guarding the ball, and that will help alleviate some of the pressures being put on our post guys.
Coach, how much confidence can those kids get, like Admiral and Kyle, when they see game tape of them, you know, kind of getting it done in the second half up there? Can that jumpstart their development?
Well, again, they made shots. That's what caught everybody's attention. But when you look at them on the other end, you know, Kyle, from the beginning, has worked pretty hard defensively. But Admiral needs to – the reason – what's holding him back is just his defense. I mean, he's got to be able to guard. We're having problems with guys that are playing a lot of minutes staying in front of the ball. Then when you go to the bench and you want him, you want Dietrich. I go down the line with every one of them. We've got to stay in front of the basketball. But there's no doubt we've always felt that Admiral could score the ball. But what he Shabari have to understand is shot selection. Again, that you make shots. You know, there's an old saying that it makes up for a multitude of sins. But the fact is, at some point in time, we still have to guard people to get this team where we want it to be, and that's where he and Shabari, Shabari probably struggles more just with shot selection, and Admiral's just really struggling on the defensive end.
And Kevin Punter, 7 games in, what's he doing at point guard that you like? What do you still need to see more of?
Well, consistency, and I think that he, again, I think the biggest thing we need from Kevin is defense. again, we're not asking him to be a lockdown defender. We're not asking him to do that. We're just asking him to be as solid as he can be and really work hard at staying in front of the ball, play position, not put himself in situations where he's reaching and trying to make great plays on the defensive end. We just need him to be a really solid defender. As a team, we need that, as opposed to trying to where he needs to improve is do his work early, get himself in position with his feet so he can, again, just protect our goal.
Do you go back to a training camp style practices for these 2 weeks since it's uninterrupted?
I don't know if it'd be so much that. I do think that, again, we're still trying to get guys to really understand our offense and understanding where they need to be and the importance of the details. I mean, you guys watched us enough to know that just guys getting to the corner. We shouldn't have to be coaching that anymore. That should be ingrained, but we still have a couple guys that don't do that. And that goes back to spacing. And that's probably has been the most frustrating part. You know, I mean, because we got to keep moving on in terms of, because as the season goes on, your teams are going to get better defensively for the most part that you play against, and nothing's going to be easy. So you've got to understand the importance of spacing. And so we're still dealing with that with some of the guys, and some of them not, but again, that should be a situation out where they understand they've got a space on the floor that they got to get to and keep themselves out of other guys' space, especially in transition.
Is this layoff difficult for you guys in the team, having 2 weeks between games?
Well, I think it's difficult for the guys because our practices are probably a lot harder than the games, you know, and so I think they would probably tell you they'd like to play every day as opposed to going to practice. But you know, I think you win a lot of games. You can win games in practice if you do it the right way. And to be quite frank, we're still learning how to practice the right way. You know, we could get out of practices a lot quicker if we didn't have to stop them and say, you got to get to the corner. You got to do this. This is things that we have to do. And we have to, because we're not going to let the details go unnoticed. And because that's the beginning of just allowing things to be sloppy and thinking you can get by with it against good teams. That's the things that beat you.